Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Car Design Dialogues Europe. Hope you've had a nice lunch break. Just want to remind you all, we've got a live chat function up and running. It's been a great source at the moment and up until now for some good questions and comments. So please go ahead and put your questions to the design team in this next session, which I'm delighted to host. It's with Skoda. So we're going to now take you directly over to the studio and roll some film that the Skoda team have produced.
It is fascinating how a brand has grown and developed a design language of its own. Every era has produced its own design icons. This heritage is outstanding and surprising. 125 years of history as a source of inspiration. Light will be used much more as a design element, not just for the pure lighting function. Skoda's design language is also strongly influenced by a regional tradition and culture. Architecture, Czech Cubism. This is really a gift, very individual and unique in the world. I am amazed by this spirit of engineering, the creativity in the design team, and this urge to do things in a different way.
Hi, my name is Oliver Stefani. I'm the head of the Skoda design team. I would like to introduce you shortly our work and team, our roots and our future, and also the Skoda design DNA. Our design department is a part of the Technical Development Center here in the Skoda Auto. Our main studios are located in Mladá Boleslav, the city of the central Bohemian region of the Czech Republic. But we also have an inspirational design studio in Prague, the Czech capital. And I should not forget Skoda design studios in China and India too. Our international team is composed from almost 160 designers from 25 countries, and I'm very proud of this. Because such a diversity is very important for designing cars for more than 100 countries where Skoda is setting its models today. Skoda design is divided to the exterior department led by Karl Neuhold, the interior department led by Peter Ola, including Color & Trim led by Katka Vranova and HMI by Federico Facchini. And not to forget, design management led by Peter Basler and clay and digital modeling led by Martin Bogner and Janos Barschon. We are responsible for designing all the Skoda models and cooperation with the other technical development departments inside the Skoda, as well for the communication with Volkswagen Group Design. When I came to Skoda 5 years ago, I was amazed by its heritage. Skoda is one of the four oldest car makers in the world, starting its history in the year 1895 as the Lauren and Clement, and first automobile appeared in the year 1905. In the Skoda Museum, we've got lots of inspiration about our roots and models. For instance, the Monte Carlo Popular Sport from 1935, a beautiful car. The Skoda 935, dynamic, Irish shape, very nice. And the Skoda Superb, of course. Just to name a few, are among these design jewels of its time. Also, our sporty heritage and models from 70s as the Felicia Cabrio Coupe 110R or rally special Skoda 130RS were pretty emotional cars of its era. With our heritage of more than 125 years in mind, we are designing the future. And we have a lot to do. In the end of the year 2019, we've presented the all-new Octavia, our iconic model and bestseller in its fourth generation, and awarded by the Red Dot for design. Last year, following our Vision IV show car, we presented the first full-size electric car in the Skoda history, the Enyaq IV. We will show you more about it in our film. This year, we have 8 world premieres. The new Skoda Fabia. The car is important not only for us, but for the whole Volkswagen Group. Special models are presented for India as the Skoda Kushaq and for China as the Octavia Pro. And we will introduce also great derivatives from the Enyaq IV later this year. To design Skoda, we are using our own design DNA, composed from well-known simply clever ideas, keeping our cars practical and human-friendly. The crystalline design language, inspired by Bohemian crystal glass craft and art, making our cars unique. And the simply surprising design for the Skoda next generation, making our cars even more emotional and recognizable in this new era of the automotive world. My colleagues will tell you more on their teams and the work they are responsible for. And we will show you the story about designing the Skoda Enyaq IV. I hope you will like it, and perhaps you will be inspired by our work. Looking forward to meet you in the Car Design News live stream soon.
A brand to love. But how do you create such a thing? A strong bond between people and the brand that makes Skoda unique. Our answer will be through great design. As is with every excellent invention, Skoda's design starts with a rough idea on paper. An idea that is being carefully sharpened, styled, and refined to perfection by a dedicated team of minds. Great design needs a lot of care from the beginning. The model is measured and sized, then viewed and judged from every angle. Everything has to fit its purpose and delight the eye. When the harmony of line and shape is finally reached, the overall perfection comes to life. Behold the clear and precise design, dynamic and crystalline at the same time. Skoda Enyaq IV is a true Skoda in every respect, yet it has a brave, new, and elegant look, thanks to different and well-thought-of proportions. The beauty of this newly found balance is being reflected in every little detail. It's the way the light complements the lines, and shade is shaped to help achieve the desired tone of color. It's a world of its own, where everything goes together and has its exact purpose fulfilled. The new Skoda Enyaq IV exterior is more than just a sum of its parts. It stands for greatness in all its simplicity. And it all comes to life when you set it in motion. It's the movement that creates the emotion. Because, as every Skoda, it's designed with you and your feelings in mind. Wherever life takes you.
My name is Peter Matushinets. and I would like to tell you a little bit about the exterior department at Skoda Design. Our department is led by Karl Neuhold, head of the exterior design, who will join you later in the live stream. Exterior design department consists of two main teams. I'm leading the exterior team number one. Team number two is led by Jirka Hraščák. Both teams work on many different design topics. We are creating future visions, the show cars and the production cars. We are also responsible for the exterior design criteria, so important for the Skoda brand, unique design and identity. Exterior design department at Skoda has got also two special teams. The light design led by Peter Nevřela, who is responsible for all the lamps and exterior light elements. Peter will tell you later more on their work, especially on the quite unique crystal face for the Enyaq IV. The next team is the wheel design led by Radim Lísek, responsible for the characteristic and original Skoda wheel style. Crystal surfaces, cuts, twisted surfacing, and strong decorative and graphical elements making our wheel rims outstanding and unique. We are also responsible for the exterior design feasibility, where we cooperate on a daily basis with our colleagues from the Skoda Technical Development Department. For all of us, it's important to make the Skoda exterior its look and style characteristic, original and emotional, yet recognizable as the Skoda. Based on our design DNA, from simply clever ideas to the crystalline design language, inspired by the original Bohemia crystal glass art, we are designing cars for customers in more than 100 countries, and it's quite challenging. Respecting our strong Skoda DNA, we are dealing with generous volumes and strong details. If you look at the diversity of the Skoda model line today, you will see cars as different by the size and other parameters, as are the Skoda Citigo, Fabia, Scala, Kamiq, and all their variants and derivatives, not to forget our special models for India, the Kushaq or China, the Kodiaq GT or coming Octavia Pro. No matter of their size, all our cars are about the good proportion. We are always want to create timeless design, visual clean and recognizable. For example, every Skoda model shows the power dome, proudly holding the Skoda logo and grille with the vertical ribs. Typical for all the Skoda cars is also the C graphic in the tail lamps, and our aim is to make each model with its own character, keeping all the Skoda quality. We are always pleased when Skoda is awarded by the media or design experts, such as the red dot for Octavia or other our models. But the most important for us in the Skoda design is to satisfy our customer needs for a nice Skoda car to own. For them, we want to create now and in the future positively, simply surprising design and the brand to love.
My name is Peter Olach, and I'm head of interior design at Skoda. This makes me responsible for three departments: interior architecture, user experience, color and trim, and a very special team of interior feasibility. Interior architecture is the department that deals with overall architecture of our cars, creates interior visions, design criteria, and distributes the volumes around the user. This department is responsible as well for all physical details like steering wheels, seats, and controllers. Currently, Marwan Kiat and Dimitris Darkoudis leads the teams. Speaking about the architecture, Skoda cars are democratic, symmetric, emphasizing the space and roominess. The most important for us are the passengers on board, whether they sit behind the steering wheel, co-driver seat, or even kids in the back seats. In order to get the best comfort and experience on board, we do create very pure, perfectly stretched volumes that accommodate precise details and controllers that appear almost like jewels. Everything is designed in a way that it should be. As an example, I can mention the textile dashboard wing that is shaped in the typical Skoda line, feature that you might know from the front bonnet of our cars. On the other hand, this has as well very unique function, as the surface under the touchscreen provides the user the great support for the hand by the interaction. The next one would be the UX/UI department, led by Federico Fajini. He and his team are responsible to the overall user experience with our products, and the focus here is the best user interface. Our cars must be working in a very easy way. You have to operate them in an easy way. They have to be very understandable. In order to achieve this, we need the right combination of physical and virtual controllers. Physical feedback plays a big role here. The best example here would be that you sit for the first time in your new Skoda and you will immediately know how to drive it and use it. As well, the personalization plays a significant role here. The third department is the color and trim department, led by Katerina Vranova. They are responsible for all the colors, structures, and materials in the interiors and exteriors of our cars. In interior, we try to stay true to the usage of all the parts. All the structural parts should be hard. The parts that are in contact with your body should be soft and inviting. This is as well the reason why we do apply various textiles even on the dashboard. The details has to look precise, good to touch. With another word, you should feel in your car as at home in your living room. That is where our design selections, personally curated by our designers, comes from. Not to forget a very special team. It would be the feasibility team led by Jan Diedek. His work is to translate all our great visions into the final product that hits the road and makes its way to the customers. The perfect products come to life only when all the involved parties work in the perfect harmony and real teamwork is present. This is how I would describe interior design at Skoda.
Teamwork is yet again the key, and the spirit of creative collaboration is deeply rooted throughout the whole designing process. For coming up with the perfect car interior, you have to go below the superficial character of things and discover what makes the inside count all the way through. This is far from scratching the surface. To step in means to employ more senses than your eyes only. Because this is not limited to what you see. When talking about the car interior, you simply have to feel it. And with the new Skoda Enyaq iV, we really made a great deal of it to feel right. All the textures, materials, different kinds of fabric and metal, all of those tailored in a fancy yet functional manner, form the spectacular familiarity of the Skoda Enyaq iV design selections. It welcomes you and makes you feel there at home, because that's exactly where we draw our inspiration from. Interior design and architecture. And it goes way beyond the complementing materials and upholstery used. The smart interface of the dashboard and the sleek steering wheel goes hand in hand with the elaborate function-first design, while still providing the warm sensation of being made to fit your needs and mood. There's immense research behind the interior design. A lot of inspiration stems directly from the craftsmanship of Czech glass workers, a national heritage of similar importance as Skoda. While it all leads back to the honest craft of the past, it points to the future with the way it uses the traditional methods and materials while creating a modern testament to human-centered design. The one you might not even notice at first, because that's how it should work. Just wait when the new Skoda Enyaq IV opens up for you. There will be a whole world of possibilities in front and all around you.
My name is Kateřina Vránová and I am head of color and trim department at Skoda Design. The color and trim is one of the smallest designers' team. We take care about all the colors and materials in the interiors and on exteriors of the Skoda cars. On the picture you can see almost all of our color and trim team. Actually, one colleague is missing. As you can see, we are mixed of genders, nationalities and age, which brings lots of advantages to our work. Everyone from our team is the expert for certain material or part of the car. Most of the people think that our work is mainly about developing or designing the exterior body color or seat upholstery, but we are responsible for much more. For example, for colors of the wheels, we are designing logos and plugs, all the grains and structures in and out, headliner materials, seat belts, carpets, colors for every single part in the vehicle. We have to specify approximately 250 items for each car. Of course, depends on the specific project. Work on every car begins for us at the same time as for our colleagues from the exterior and interior departments. Close cooperation between designers is more than important, and it is one of the keys for success. The mood boards are necessary for the future design directions, colors, and materials of each project. This is also one of the most creative work for the color and trim designer. We are getting inspiration from the architecture, from fashion industry, from the art, and from nature, and also material work. These three mood pictures and colors were based for three current levels, interiors of the Enyaq IV project. We are always getting first inputs from the Skoda marketing department. It is very important to know for which customers we are developing specific car, what will be the size, and also the price range. During the development process, we have to take care about the feasibility, quality test results of all materials, their costs, which means lots of internal discussions within Skoda, but also external discussions with our suppliers. Whole design development process of the colors and trims take approximately 2 years, including of the internal presentations to the Skoda board. Work on the Enyaq IV was especially in the way that we got more freedom to create new interior concepts. We made several versions of interiors called design selections. Each design selection is different and named by the style of living space. As people are spending more time in their cars, they want to feel more comfortable and they care much more about the materials. They are interested in its properties and haptics, and of course, colors too. We are more and more focusing on the sustainable materials, same as our customers. And I believe that this theme is future not only for the car industry. We really enjoyed to work on the Enyaq IV, and we are very happy about first positive feedbacks. We proved that materials themselves are getting more important than in the past. I believe that you will appreciate the result of our work at Skoda, especially color and trim team, and that every customer will find what is looking for and will make right choice.
Do what the future of car interior design looks like? Well, just like your living room. Space fitted to your style and needs, and therefore distinctly yours. But let's ask the experts from Skoda Auto responsible for the design themselves.
At Color and Trim, we monitor the newest trends and focus what's absolutely essential for a good driving feeling. Then we decide on what materials we should use and how we should treat them. For the new Skoda Enyaq iV, we were inspired by the idea of stepping into your favorite kind of a room and then taking it for a drive in an all-electric SUV.
And therefore, each interior trim, from fabric material to upholstery detail, is based on a contemporary living room representing a personality as unique and special as your own. You may now choose from 5 standard selections with 3 additional lifestyle ones available soon. So let's have a look together at each of the Skoda Enyaq iV design selections. As the title suggests, the Sportline interior option is the pure manifestation of a fast-forward spirit. It sports a dynamic appearance thanks to its exquisite Suedia seats with a 2-turn perforation accented by light grey details and accompanied by carbon decor. With its fresh approach to material design, Sportline might easily turn every daily duty into a fast-paced adventure. If you need a boost of energy every time you hop into your car, look no further.
It was nice to be able to experience firsthand each of the new Skoda Enyaq iV design selections. So, now you know where to look for the future of car interior design. It's right there. Because it's what's inside that matters.
My name is Petr Nevřela and I am lead exterior lighting designer at Skoda Design. Together with my colleagues, Martin Patzl and Michal Hess, we designed the lamps of all Skoda production models and show cars. Whole development time of the lamps is the same as development time of complete car. At the beginning, there is the most creative period where we work with the inspiration from different fields of design and art. We set up design directions and strategies. We explore concept alternatives. And we intensively cooperate with exterior design. It's a big passion to design lighting parts of the car. Imagine that you underline car exterior with piece of jewelry, which completes appearance of the car and brings the character through the light expression. During the intensive cooperation with technical departments, we developed original concepts into the final products. Once you get it on the road, your proposal starts its lifetime, helping our customers in the night with the visibility, supporting the design identity, and of course, safety of your car. We developed a link between the Czech crystal glass and its modern interpretation in automotive design. Crystal glass offers us never-ending inspiration. You can always enjoy original show, which makes the moment unique. That's why we use glass elements in our show cars. It always brings inspirational and impressive effects, which we later transfer to production world. It's a very exciting moment when you can design completely new feature on the car. So you can imagine, for example, what a challenge appeared when we decided to transfer for the first time our illuminated front mask from show cars to the series production. We found a way how to handle all the feasibility and safety requirements without losing the design intention. Crystal face, how we call it, represents crystalline design in every detail and fits perfectly to our first fully electric model, Skoda Enyaq. And what comes next? We will further develop our crystalline design in innovative way and at the same time with big respect to our characteristic features like C-shape rear signature or crystalline ice block signature in the front.
Hmm.
what an amazing design film there from the Skoda team. We've now got a brilliant opportunity to ask them some questions about the Enyaq IV, their first electric SUV, and more. So it's my pleasure to take you right over to the Skoda design studio now.
Hi, Michael. Good to see you.
Good to see you too. Thank you so much for joining us. So I think we'll just start with a question about the prolific nature of Skoda design. So it was mentioned there in the film that you're going to be releasing 8 new cars this year. So we've got the new Fabia, obviously, and the Kushaq, which I think is being launched tomorrow. Very exciting times. So you must be very, very busy right now.
Yeah, Michael, let me say in the beginning, so on the behalf of my team that I have here with me in the Prague studio, so we really welcome you, and it's a great honor, and it's really nice that we are being part of this program. We're always very busy, I have to say. Even now, when the cars are finished, we're busy with the next cars. So this is always in the design, yeah? And we like it this way, yeah? So, but we're looking forward for all these new cars that are coming out, and it's busy times, but it's good like this, yeah?
Yeah, fantastic. And it's great to have you and your wider team, Oliver. Whereabouts exactly are you joining us from? Which studio?
Sorry?
Which studio are you joining us from?
Oh, right, yeah. So we are here in Prague, yeah? So we have our main studio in Mladá Boleslav. That's about 45 minutes away from to the north. And we have here right next to the Moldau River in this beautiful, one of the beautiful areas from Prague, we have here this little Prague studio in the fifth floor overlooking the old town and the Karls Bridge, you know? And this is some kind of our small, I would say, advanced studio, yeah? So where the people come here, work on these projects, it's a bit free thinking. It's a great place. I also love to be here, but unfortunately, I not always have the time to come here, yeah? But you see, it's really nice building. It's not big, yeah? It's quite small, the studio. Looking out of the window is a beautiful view, so it's really great.
Nice, very, very cool. Yeah, so let's jump into the Enyaq IV. We've touched upon this kind of theme a few times already today, and that's the idea of how electrification is having an impact on car design. So perhaps Oliver and yourself and your team could tell us how electrification played a role in shaping the Enyaq IV. I guess it's particularly important considering it's an SUV as well.
Yeah, I mean, this is our first BEV car, battery electric vehicle. And of course, there's a lot of chances, but also challenges. Yeah, so the overall proportions, the battery, the aerodynamics, and all this kind of stuff. But I would like to give this answer also to my dear colleague, Karl Neuhold. So, and he can probably also explain this quite nicely. Karl.
Okay. Yeah, hello, dear colleagues everywhere around the world. Yeah, also from my side to the exterior topic of the Enyaq IV, I have to say, as you know, we wanted to make, especially for the electric driven vehicle, not our only singular and different family to the actual model portfolio, but we wanted to say, okay, we want to incorporate, even it's a different drivetrain, also into our product and design language of all our Skoda model range. And therefore as well, you see, it still fits because we see it as our electric car as a flagship of the MEB platform compared to the other Kodiaq and the Superb on the other side. But still, we wanted to incorporate it, but still giving its own identity. When you look on the proportions of it, we have not only that we have a bigger wheels, but also you see as well, we have a quite short overhang. We have a quite fast front window. We have a very sloopy roof line just to fulfill great aerodynamical issues. But still, it fits to the Skoda family. Because as you know, we produce per year about 1 million cars. And therefore as well, this car should as well fit into our range that people recognize it's a true Skoda, But still, with some unique goodies, as we said just before as well, we have a closed grille, but we show, as we said, light is the new chrome. Therefore, we wanted to show and express with the crystal face something new, innovative, and looking forward.
And Michael, this question has a second answer, because also there was a lot of things new in the interior as well. Yeah, and this offers also a lot of opportunities. And Peter Ola, head of interior design, will explain this a little bit.
Hello, Michael. Hi, everyone as well from the interior side of our studio. I mean, for us in interior, to work on electric car and the one similar to Enyaq was almost like a dream, because the package is the dream package. The battery allows us to have very low, very flat floor. The exterior guys did an amazing job, and they moved the wheels completely to the corners of the whole car. So we have really a free playground to do something completely new. And therefore, for example, when we started to work on the dashboard, we had a chance to have very lightweight dashboard, a huge space. Then the middle console, we are not having a conventional shifter. So therefore, the middle console can be completely free floating in the space. You could find different storages on the middle console from the top. Then you find the storage under the middle console. As I said, the floor is completely flat, gives very, very cozy feeling. In the car, there is as well a lot of light thanks to the greenhouse. So this all creates almost an atmosphere as you would be sitting at home in your living room. And thanks to this as well, Katka Vranova and her team, they did amazing job regarding the materiality, regarding the sustainability. And this all creates this very unique package of Enyaq.
Fantastic, guys. Thank you so much for those answers. We're having a lot of questions through via the chat. Please keep sending them through. But I'm going to be greedy, because I've got you guys on the call and I want to ask one of my own questions. You mentioned heritage a little bit there. In the film, obviously Skoda has such a strong heritage. Just recently, actually, I published a feature on the CDM website regarding your Icons Revisited project that the team did, where you took several models. I think it was the Voiturette, the Felicia, the Popular Monte Carlo, 1203 van, and the 130 RS. And it was such an interesting project, and I was really inspired by that. I thought it was brilliant. But I just wondered, could you go into a little bit more depth about when you're producing a new model, specifically something like the Enyaq IV, your first electric SUV, which really needs to push the boundaries in terms of design. It really needs to move forward. How do you subtly bring in that heritage as well?
Yeah, this heritage is incorporated also already in our design DNA and in the strategy that we have. So we have a long history, as you were saying. It's 125 years. There's a lot of cars. We're taking a lot of inspiration from these cars. For instance, in the headlights, if you look at this Monte Carlo Popular, and they have also some super chrome covers on the headlight. And this idea was also inspiring us for these eyelashes that we have in our Enyaq, in the day running light signature. So we're quite often in the museum and just go through the exhibition there, and we always find something interesting. Yeah, if it's color and trim, if it's colors in general, or how to use this, some detail work. It's a constant inspiration for us. Yeah, but of course also we're trying then to develop this inspiration into something very modern, very unique, so that fits to Skoda design.
Yeah, fantastic. Okay, so we're having a lot of questions about the exterior design, and particularly people are really interested in the face of the Enyaq IV and that crystal grille. Could you perhaps outline the thinking behind the crystal grille and go into a little bit more detail for us?
Yeah. Okay, I would like also to hand over this question to Peter Nafchler, who sits behind me. And Peter, please.
Yeah, exactly. That was the right moment when we decided to transfer it for the first time into the production, you know, because we showed that film several times on our show cars. Every time we were playing with these small glass elements, real glass elements, in different way. And with Enyaq, it was the moment when we said, what about to test it and what about to try it for the first time into the production world? And that was really amazing moment, really nice challenge, because we had different layout because of this electric character of the car. So the space behind the front mask was a little bit different. And at the same time, we had really big source of inspiration with the show cars, which we were already doing till that time. So we tried that, we found a way, and it was great because everything connected into the working group of design lighting elements. It's kind of linked into the past, as we mentioned, for example, Škoda Popular Monte Carlo, because there you can see also the theme which is going through all the front of the car. And at the same time, it's looking to, let's say, future, because this is completely new interpretation using the, let's say, theme of light. So that was really a stunning moment when we decided for this theme.
Yeah, let me add to this. I mean, whenever you do this electric car, yeah, you talk about the front and what to do with the grill. Yeah, if you don't want to have a grill, you take it out or we leave it in. But Skoda has also such a long tradition with this face, and we developed over this last 30 years the face so that we just didn't want to throw it away. Yeah, but we needed some new interpretation what to do with this area, and we had shown this on the show cars. And light is something that is also incorporated in this bohemian crystal idea, yeah? Because glass and crystal, when they have, when you add this with light, then it really shines up and looks super cool, yeah? And that's why we put all to this together and developed this crystal face. And I have to say, seeing this outside, seeing this at night, it really looks great.
Yeah, I can't wait to see it in person. It looks fantastic from the images that I've seen. My colleagues here in the studio, they've been really kind to me and let me take on this session because they know that I hold Skoda quite dearly. I'm quite a fan of yours. And one of the things that I really find when I get inside a Skoda vehicle is the interior, the finish, the materials. Everything seems relaxing to me and everything seems to work perfectly. And you mentioned in the film about it being almost like a living room in your home. Could we talk a little bit more about that, how the Enyaq IV is you know, the interior finish, how it's comfortable and works very well?
Sure, Michael, we can do. And I think Katka Vranova is the best person that can give you an answer about this, yeah?
Yeah, sure. Like, actually, hello from my side as well. So, like we said also in the movie, and Peter and Oliver mentioned it, with Enyaq IV, we're introducing the new way of the selling the cars. Actually, we call it design selection. And we were inspired by way of living, different space. That's why we call our levels not anymore like you used to have it, but like the basic one is studio, loft, lounge, and the suite, and so on. So we create every single interior as a living space, as a full concept, and we focus on every single detail, not only on the seat materials, but also as we describe in the movie, we use the soft materials on the pad, on the doors, and everything is perfectly matching together. And of course, because we are color and trim, we definitely not forget also about the colors. So you will see really lots of new colors and new way of the interiors. So that's why we call it design selection, and that you are feeling like in living room.
Michael, this living room issue is really important for us, yeah, because the way that you drive an electric car and the experience that you have with electric car is totally different, yeah. It's quiet. It's almost like a little bit like sailing. Somebody was saying it's like flying, yeah. And this inviting interior concept, also with the materials, I think is something what you expect then also when you're in this kind of atmosphere. And this is also what we would like as to give to our customers this welcoming, inviting feeling, a little bit like a home. Yeah, this is really important for us, and this is also some kind of Skoda DNA.
Yeah, that's something that I was going to pick up on as well. Moving back to that electric element, there must have been some tricky things in the interior. That, you know, it does lend itself to having perhaps some more space, different layout, but there must have been tricky things that you've had to do to cut out some noises that might not be there in an internal combustion engine car, right?
Peter, maybe it's for you.
I mean, it's more about sound design, what you ask. But in general, as Oliver said, driving electric car is really like flying. So basically, you are in perfect silence, perfect tranquility in the interior. So, and this is where the roots of Skoda are coming from. We are a brand which focuses on the family and well-being and a cocooning, maybe. So if you are in your car, you should feel perfectly protected, perfectly safe in your own world. And in that direction, we always try to steer our thoughts. So to isolate all the sounds which are unnecessary, to have a perfect clustering of the information that you as a passenger or driver are perceiving, sometimes reduce, sometimes we really realize in our world nowadays, we are really overwhelmed by the information. So all these are the keys how to create a perfect interior.
Yeah, great, fantastic. I just wanted to, we're having a few more questions in, but I just wanted to ask about collaboration between the studios in Skoda as well. Was the Enyaq IV something entirely produced in Europe, or did you have other insights from your other studios too?
Yeah, these projects are always a little bit of a cooperation, yeah. So we ask different studios, different places to work on, yeah. So because we want to have a really diverse answer also to this question, especially when it's such an important project. So yes, we do this, and we are very fond of this. It's a very good process to collect these ideas, yeah. Because, I mean, design is always, you have to things also, sometimes you have to things, let them happen, yeah? So to see what develops from this, yeah? If you cut any good idea from the beginning, yeah? So I think this is not what I would like to do. So I really would like to see where it's going, you know, and if it's helping us to find something new for the future. So, and for this to have different people, different studios working on this is always a great idea and a good chance.
Okay, great, yeah. You touched on it there, Oliver. My next question was going to be, do you think that the Enyaq IV and the design that you have there with the new model, do you think that it's kind of a point of direction for the next wave of Skodas that are about to be released?
It's these cars are when they're coming out, you know, so we're already working on the next generation of cars, let's say, yeah. And of course it's a stepstone also to the future, yeah. It will guide us, of course, yeah. Some of the things will always stay because they're natural Skoda design criteria or DNA, as I said before, yeah. But of course we're constantly also developing this, yeah. The world is changing, some things getting more important, some things getting less important. And so this is also what drives us, you know. And you will see that the way we develop this car will be very also surprising, yeah. And but I can't say, of course, at the moment so much about this. You have to wait a little bit, but we're on the direction, yeah.
Okay, brilliant. I think that's a good point to wrap it up. So thank you guys ever so much for joining us and taking us inside your studio. It's been an absolute pleasure to speak to you. And really great film and very interesting. So thank you for spending the time to speak at Car Design Dialogues.
Michael, thank you. Thanks a lot from our side. And it was a really pleasure to be here. Yeah, thank you.
Brilliant. Okay, so we will be right back with a panel discussion from Adobe after a short break.
Is an award-winning organization and recognized leader in the creation of prototypes, full-scale props and mock-ups, and the most technically advanced concept vehicles for the automotive, aviation, and mobility industries. The company is also a source for contract manufacturing, low-volume specialty vehicles, production paint programs, and component assembly. With nearly 300 employees and four impressive Midwestern USA facilities, Prefix offers an extremely wide range of capabilities, providing clients with a one-stop shop of crucial services. Actively involved with advanced technologies relating to electric vehicles, autonomous transportation, and urban mobility, Prefix has the departments and skills needed to work with companies throughout the entire development process.
Marching to the drums like pa 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 pa, sliding by the beach, just gotta We'll be right back.